Thank you so much. Closing ceremonies are over. Thank you. Great Derbycon. No, seriously, take off the noses. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know if everybody saw, but what was it, Saturday night, Adrian, or Friday night?
Friday night.
I'm downstairs. Well, no, someone comes upstairs. I'm on the level of my floor, and someone comes on like, listen, this didn't come for me, but there is like a seriously scary clown on the second floor looking for you, and I'm like, no chance of me going downstairs. And so I end up going down to the very first floor, and I'm looking around, and it turned out to be Adrian, but Adrian's like circling around looking at me as he's walking. I mean, it's the freakiest thing ever. Like, and that same day, no BS, that same day, someone was arrested in Louisville for trying to lure people into the woods as a clown. And so I'm like, Adrian, do I got to bail you out or something? You know, like, it wasn't him, but... Oh, man. Well, thank you all for coming to the closing ceremonies. It's been a great and fantastic DerbyCon. I mean, what a great DerbyCon, huh? I honestly feel like for us, we may say this every year, but it really does feel like the best DerbyCon yet. And I mean, everything from day one when we started the training to when everybody started arriving and coming through the doors and starting to see everybody and start to meet new people. And, you know, when we did the first opening ceremonies and people raised their hands and, you know, who was the first time coming to DerbyCon? And like 80% of the audience, you know, was brand new to DerbyCon and got to experience what we're trying to do here. So, you know, I want to give a round of applause for everybody here, the attendees that made the conference the way it is and that feel that we have here, because it is special. So thank you, attendees. So we were talking, I was actually talking to Ed Skotis today. Is Ed here still? It's back there. Ed and I were talking, and, you know, he said something to the fact of how it really feels like we're recharged right now. Like we, you know, feel fresh to go and do things in this industry. And while we might be extremely tired, it's a unique feeling that we're recharged maybe mentally, but physically our bodies literally just want to give out on us at this point in time. So, you know, it's a unique feeling wanting to go and leave. But it was I was talking to somebody else earlier, and it's funny, you can see my Git commits on GitHub. You know, the first 6 months after DerbyCon, I released like insane amount of code, and then I started to deplete a little bit again, and I started to lose. But, you know, so expect a new version of set coming out in the next couple of weeks, I'm sure. But what I want to say is, you know, hopefully you leave here and you go and you do good things. I think there's a lot of stuff in this industry that is noise. There's a lot of negative folks in this industry. There's no need for it. We have so many brilliant minds here doing some great things. And I just, I was talking to somebody and he said, you know, 2 years ago, or it was a year ago, was my very first DerbyCon, and I watched a talk on OSINT. And after that, I started looking and researching OSINT, and I became, you know, a PI firm, and I got my first job in OSINT, and I submitted a speaking talk here, and I got accepted and presented at my first DerbyCon. That's what DerbyCon is about. You all here have a chance to speak here, to present, to, you know, better your careers, to do what you need to. Everybody here has the tools and capabilities of getting better and doing what you do. So I just want to again say thank you all for making DerbyCon and continuing to grow with us and the family. So thank you. Special thanks to all of our sponsors. Was Milton Security great? I mean, come on. The Hyatt is awesome. So, you know, someone came upstairs, one of the Hyatt members came upstairs and like, listen, we have a food and liquor license, so the folks over there can't be doing shots. And you're technically not supposed to be cooking hot dogs and popcorn, but if you can get rid of the shots, we'll allow the hot dogs and the popcorn to stay. So it's like a barter system. Like, okay, I guess I can get them to stop doing the shots, you know. So we nuked the shots for a little bit, and then it came back later on, whatever. But, you know, Milton was great. There's some great folks. Cobalt Strike with Raph was awesome. I mean, we just really have a great amount of sponsors here that make this possible. I mean, everybody in the booth here, hopefully you went and said hi to them. They're all really great folks trying to do good things as well, so I really appreciate all the sponsors. Can we give a huge, huge round of applause for the Hyatt staff? They are absolutely amazing. I mean, from every aspect of what they do. You know, it's funny because last night I had a spur-of-the-moment thing happen for 7 o'clock in the morning, and they needed to set the room up. And I just talked to Ryan. I'm like, hey, man, can you go and set this up? And he's like, yep, no problem. I'm working all night, so I'll have the room set up. Came in. The room is completely clean, ready to go. I mean, they're spot on for what they do, and they really care about us. And, I mean, come on, to deal with us the way that they do, and they laugh at it. I mean, what was there, a bra hanging from the ceiling again? Is that becoming a tradition now? I mean, whoever's doing the bra thing, it's really funny. If you can please stop it next year. Clearing the parachutes ahead of time, by the way. I heard the it's an A-OK to drop a parachute off of the 18th floor or whatever, so congrats on that. I think Dustin, every year, that's you. Renderman, where's he at? Where's Render at? Render, I saw Render on Twitter. He's like, hey, Einstein Bagels, you forgot to lock your door, but don't worry, we locked it for you. You know, good, being a good citizen. So this morning, I go to Einstein and Bagels. I'm like, hey, just so you folks know, your doors were locked, are not locked, they're left open. And she looks at me and she looks over there and I'm like, don't worry, we locked them for you. And it took her a second. She's like, oh, thank you so much. You know, that's so, wait, how did you lock them? I'm like, you don't know who we are, you know, hey. But what's funny about that is I got a free bagel. So thanks, Render, I appreciate that. Yeah. So, again, thanks again to the Hyatt that made this possible. And, you know, again, we still have one more year. If you weren't here during open ceremonies, we are moving to the Marriott, which we'll, you know, really, really miss the Hyatt. But we have one more year at the Hyatt next year, so don't go booking your hotel rooms in the Marriott thinking it's there. It's going to be here next year. We'll throw them an awesome party here, and then next year we'll be moving, the year after that we'll be moving to the Marriott. Kelly, everybody get Kelly the bartender? Yeah? So, story about Oh, and Gene, obviously. Gene is just amazing as well. We love them both. But Kelly, yesterday, looked like he was a defeated man. He was sweating. He was tired. I'm like, hey, man, how you doing? He's like, you guys, man. You guys, I don't know what's going on, but you're cleaning us out of everything. I'm like, well, did we beat last year? He's like, I don't even know. It's bad. We're in trouble. I'm like, well, can I get shots of fire? But no, we're out of that. I'm like, can I get shots of no? We're out of that. No, can I get shots? No, we're out of that. I'm like, can you make me something? He's like, I don't know what I'm going to make, but I'll make you something. I'm like, okay. So I don't know what the record is, but I'll definitely make sure once we get the stats from the Hyatt that we post those up, because every year we seem to absolutely destroy them. And, you know, it's funny. They were getting a little nervous. I think it was like Wednesday night was a little slow because everybody was in training. And they're like, man, you guys are like slow this year for some reason. I'm like, oh, just you wait. You should know by now, you know. So, again, kudos to the Hyatt, Lou, and all those folks that are doing this. So, level one, you want to come up here for the black badges? So, I'm really, really, really excited about this year's black badges. And, I mean, first of all, they are wonderful. They make their own badges. And if you're doing a con, get them to do your badges. They are friggin' fantastic badges. So, I'll pass it over to them. We're going to do this. Let me go up front here. Oh, here, we'll go up front here.
Yeah. All right. So I am the Blinster. This is the hat. And together we are Mr. Blinky Bling. We started doing this because of Derbycon. Believe it or not, the Mega Bling here came out of one of the Crystal Method concerts, and I didn't know if I had the brightest LEDs, and I made really sure that I had them the next year. And Charles, my good friend, helped me do that because he does all the electrical engineering, and we collaborate on the design work. But so we started making these. People started saying, you know, shut up and take our money. And so we decided to start Mr. Blinky Bling and do that to make LED wearables and such like that. In the process of doing that, we stumbled into STEM education kits because Charles and I like to go to events like this and teach people and kids how to solder. So having taught thousands of people to solder, we discovered some of the weaknesses in soldering kits. And we've decided to make our own. We have custom footprints. These are easier to assemble, easier to work with, and we will put your logo on them. So if you're interested in that, please get with us at Mr. Blinky Bling, and we'd be delighted to do that. But for now, we get to talk about these. We have been sitting on this for like 5 months. They reached out and said, or we reached out to them, and we're like, hey, we want to do a badge business. Can we make badges for you guys? And they said, well, we can't do badges for everyone this year, but would you be interested in doing our black badges? And we said, yeah. And we had a couple of cool conversations, and they sent us the artwork. And so we have over 170 LEDs that I hand-soldered on this bad boy yesterday. And And I'm real proud of myself. I got the front of this board done in like an hour and 10 minutes. And then I ran out of steam, and it took me about 2 hours to do the back of the board. But Charles was up all night writing the code for this. It's got two microcontrollers on there controlling all of these LEDs. They're Charlieplexed, and it has capacitive touch sensors. So we took the theme of the Recharge logo and the ideas they had for having the various colors like a battery bar, and animated it. And then we added some capacitive touch sensors so you can switch between animations. And then just because they're capacitive touch sensors, we added a couple of Easter eggs. So if you win one of these, you have to play with it or get with us and see if you can social engineer some of the answers out. But it's been an absolute pleasure to be able to build these for you guys, and we're super excited to finally show you how awesome this is.
Just awesome. Again, every year, something different, something better that we do here, and the folks that help contribute to making this conference. I mean, we don't know how to do half the stuff that's going on here. In fact, we don't know how to do any of the stuff that we got going on. Except Martin. Martin and Ninewires, Jason over there, know how to do the sound and stuff, but we have no idea what we're doing. So having folks coming up and helping out totally makes this all possible. Is Eric, Yvonne, and Rob here from Nolicon by any chance? Eric, come here, Eric. Come up here real quick. So we started this tradition a few years ago, and we look at conferences that are doing the same thing or trying to do the same thing or building the message around community, family, and everything else. And I got the experience of going to a NOLACon this year, and I loved it. Another great family con. It's great. Yvonne and Rob invited us into their house and cooked food for us, in their own house. And there was 60 hackers jam-packed into their house, just basically, eating all their crawfish and all the crazy New Orleans stuff that you get in there. I don't know what half the stuff was. It was good, though. But, one thing that we like to do is recognize conferences that do that. And a few years ago, we gave SkydogCon and HackerCon black badges. We'd like to do the same for NOLACon. So, Eric, Yvonne, and Rob, you guys have black badges for life at Derbycon, man, all right?
I mean, we're incredibly humbled to have had you come down, and we appreciate it. We appreciate all your support. Anybody wants to come down to NOLACon in May, come on down. Please, CFP open soon.
BourbonCon.
Thanks. For everybody who doesn't know BourbonCon, we've done it every year that DerbyCon's been going on. We started out at maybe 20, 25 people hanging out at Jockey Silks up at Galt House the first year. This year we had our biggest recorded crowd ever. We got over 180 people through the door. excuse me. And so as in the past couple years, all the money that we made in addition over what it cost to put on the event is going to charity. This year we decided, in large part memory of Rance, to donate that to the Cancer Research Institute. thanks in no small part to all of our attendees, our great sponsors like Symantec, GuidePoint, B-Side Cincinnati. We were able to make $1,600 that we'll be giving as a donation to the Cancer Research Institute once we get back home. So, thank you.
Chris and Nagy.
So, if you weren't in my speech, Dave bought 20 shake weights, and he handed them out to people throughout the audience. And then as I'm talking about nonverbals, there's random people shake weighting at me. It's just so disturbing mentally to see that.
The best part about it is I see Dave, he's carrying the whole thing of shake weights. He's like, what do I do with one shake
weight? So I did get Dave back. I had a BourbonCon pass. I couldn't make that event. So I tweeted, the first person to send me a picture of them icing Dave will get a free BourbonCon pass. Something really awesome happened. At Bourbon, found the tweet. You're welcome. Retweeted it by saying, someone in Louisville find this hacking Dave guy and give him, and then tweeted at Smirnoff Ice. So.
There was like 300 people charging me with Smirnoff Ice. I'm like, what's going on?
So I got a great couple pictures of Dave getting iced, and they got a free bourbon contest. Thanks for being a good sport on that. He did get me back, though. I had all these beautiful things, and he comes in, he's like, six bags, pig. And he pulls out six bags of the stinking things. Okay, anyhow. SD Village, first year. Anybody stop in? Anybody like it this year? Great, wasn't it? Oh, my gosh. You know, it was such a great time here at Derbycon. I love this event. So we had the polygraph challenge. We did that all day Friday. And we had an 11-year-old who almost was the winner. She almost was the winner. It was really disturbing, actually. I think she may be a little sociopathic. So kind of glad she didn't win. I was scared. But we had our winner, Gary. Now, he's not here. His foster mom passed away, believe it or not, so he had to go home. So he's not here right now. And then we did something kind of impromptu. We ran a Friday night panel. I invited some of our social engineering friends up, and we just had a discussion about how to get in the industry, ethics of social engineering, and it was so amazingly successful that we did it two more times. We held three SE panels impromptu. And for those of you there, do you think we should do that again next year?
Yeah.
It was amazing. I mean, really, you guys, the discussion was so productive. I have a couple ideas that are probably going to change the face of my business. So when I have that private island, I'll invite you guys. Okay, thanks for those. Then we held the MSI, Mission SE Impossible. We kind of wanted to, in the spirit and respect for the old gringo challenge, we have like lasers and you're picking a safe and locks and handcuff shimming. And our winner, Jeff, are you here? Jeff? I thought you were going to be here. Jeff? Oh. No, Jeff? Okay. Well, we'll get him. So both the winner for the polygraph challenge and the winner for MSI got a bunch of swag from us, a coin, and they're getting a Derbycon pass, a free Derbycon pass for next year. Free? Oh, you guys have free tickets this year, and they're not here. Oh, man. Okay, I'll have to get you their email. One question. Would anyone think that having the SECTF also at Derbycon would be a good idea? Yeah. Okay. We're going to see what we can do next year. But, guys, one thing I want to say, I love you guys. I really do. Your team is amazing. You guys are the best working with you. And the training, Tim, you're amazing. You guys just totally love this con. I had multiple people this weekend. Here's the thing that happened after. Somebody came up to me and said, you and Dave are my favorite InfoSec love story. I don't know what that means, but, you know, love you guys. Love you, bro.
Yeah, that's one thing. I mean, from a staff perspective, we have the most amount of people that take the time out. We don't get paid to do any of this. We take it out of our own personal time to go and do this. I mean, everybody from the security staff that made sure everybody was safe and sound and traffic flow and everything else, all the way to, you know, DeSimon and Khalil and, you know, Martin and everybody else staying up till 4 o'clock in the morning every night trying to get the sound system going. I mean, everybody puts in the time to make this possible, to give you folks the best show that we possibly can. We're still standing today, which is amazing. I don't know if this is going to last. You know, in 10 years from now, I don't know if I'm going to still be, you know, I'll probably be in like crutches or something, you know, after four hard days of partying. But, seriously, it's really awesome. And people like Chris that take time out of their day to actually run the villages and to go and do their things. And the folks that do the level one, hardware hacking and the lock picking and the events with the CTF with Scott and everybody else that puts their time in. I'd just like to give everybody a round of applause that makes it possible. And you can see what we're doing is contagious. There's a lot of conferences out there now that are becoming more intimate because I feel like we do better research together. I feel that when we all put our minds together, we do better things. It's not about conflict. It's not about, you know, going on Twitter wars and starting crazy battles and drama and all that other stuff. It's all about working together to come up to a solution. And I don't know if you saw the talks, but they were very much focused on all parts of InfoSec. Offense, defense, incident response, SCADA, mobile, you name it. We try to get a wide breadth of those, and we had a very good balance this year of offense and defensive talks because without the two, you don't have a successful, you know, we're not going to be successful in security. So, you know, I hope everybody understands that, you know, what we're doing here is something special, and you're all a part of that. Martin, you want to talk about the sound and the... By the way, was that not the best two sets of parties you've ever seen in your entire life?
So did everybody come to the party? You know, I don't know if people know exactly how long it takes to set all this stuff up. Dave definitely doesn't. What he does is he comes in the door and he's like, "Whoa! How'd this get here?"
I thought it was magic.
The best part about Dave is, like, you know, Thursday night is crunch time on all of this. Like, actually, one more funny story. You all see this this little piece of truss here in the middle? So that's 2.5 feet. So this actually has to be measured pretty particularly because when you put up the walls, the screens have to be at a particular angle or else the projectors won't go behind them. And so this year what happened was there was a slight miscalculation. I'm not blaming anybody. But this little middle piece here was replaced with a 5-foot piece instead of a 2.5-foot piece. The entire thing was put together, lights hung, PA, everything, the whole 9 yards. And once we figured out what had happened, we had to tear the whole thing down and put the whole thing back up Wednesday night and Thursday night. So I really wanted to give a shout out to Dave, Kyle, and Jason, who, you know, and the whole sound crew at DC Productions. That stayed up basically all night long and put all Khalil. This stuff back together. And Khalil, where's Khalil? So you know, in a previous life, I used to work with a lot of this stuff, so I'm really proud of the show that we put on here. I like to make it the best that we can every year. I don't know. I know we say it all the time, but people probably don't believe us. We don't make any money off Derbycon whatsoever. And so what happens is, you know, every year, you know, we keep getting more sponsors and more companies want to be involved and that kind of thing. So we get more money, right? And so since we don't make any money, the only thing you can do with more money is spend it. And so that's why, if you'll notice, every year we have a little bit bigger act and a little bit bigger act, and we try to push the envelope just a little bit more. So I just want to say that me and Dave are seriously pushing the envelope next year. Oh, so God. We'll see what happens.
What?
Which one?
The Trusted Tech Dinner? The Trusted Tech Dinner? Oh, the funny story about the Trusted Tech Dinner. Having to go out to the Trusted Tech Dinner? I know.
So Dave does this every year. So this year, see, remember what I was talking about? He doesn't understand how all of this happens. And so, like, you know how, like, that. So Dave decides that he wants to do a team dinner for Trusted Sec, which, as you're aware, most everybody here either works for Trusted Sec or BDS. And so, you know, on Wednesday night, you know, right when we're tearing all this down and putting it all back up together, Dave says, "We're going out for a team dinner Thursday night, you know, at 8 o'clock, which is like complete crunch time." So what happens is when all the trainings go down, we have a ton of work to do. So it's the busiest time of the entire conference. So, anyway.
The sound guy's not on mic.
So,
why do you think it takes us 3 days to set up?
That's right. So anyway, we've been giving Dave a really hard time about scheduling that dinner. Needless to say, I didn't go. I didn't get any dinner.
No.
Yeah.
That's true.
Nobody up here went to the dinner except for Dave. Oh, Adrian went, so fuck both you all.
You act like I don't do a lot of work. I don't really do a lot of work, but it's fine. But, you know, these folks, I mean, they, you don't see it behind there, but a lot of things go wrong. And a lot of things happen where, you know, they're stressing out, they're running back and forth. And you're like, I know there's times where, like, you just don't talk to Martin. Like, you don't make eye contact with Martin. And then you start talking to Martin, you can tell he's, like, going like this, like he wants to get away from you, but he can't because he's trying to be courteous. But, you know, it's honestly, though, I mean, that's the type of stuff that they're dealing with and working with. So, you know, Creepy, Dave, you know, Martin and Jason back there. Jason, come here, come here. Come here, get up here. Jason hates being in front of places. Come here. Come here. Come here. This guy right here. Thank you all very much for the time and effort that you put into making that possible. You can go sit down. Thank you. All right, I think Aaron wanted 5 minutes, so Skydog had something. Skydog? Oh, over there on the left. No problem. Too much partying, it happens.
You're a scholar and a gentleman. Where are you going? You're standing right there, I'd say. Hi, everybody. I'm Skydog. This is your first year. If you've been here more than once, you're probably familiar with me. Now I got to lose weight to catch up to that guy. It's like, dude, you're screwing up the curve for everybody. So I don't want to say that Dave is busy, but I tried to talk to him for the past 3 weeks, and I finally got a response where he said, okay, I have a 20-minute window between 5:05 and 5:25 on this day. Can you make a call then? I'm like, I don't have an option, dude. That's the only time you got it. And literally, it's like, okay, I got to go. Click, and off to work again. It's another meeting. So, Yeah. You've been busy, though. You've been really busy. This is a lot of work. So we appreciate everything Dave has done. So 3 years ago, 2013, I actually got Black Badge, as he said earlier, which for me is an absolute honor to be able to wear this badge around. I appreciate it so much. So what we wanted to do was to present you with a SkydogCon Black Badge, complete with the Dave Kennedy for President button. There we go. But then the fun part about everything when we do this stuff, and Dave knows, having a staff that can make things happen. I have Evan, I have James, I have a whole crew of people that make sure everything gets done when it's supposed to get done. I'm where I'm supposed to be, where I'm supposed to be, and I don't screw up too much at one time. So the nice part about having a team of people, actually the gentleman in charge of our badges for this year is Red vs. Davies. Does anybody know Red? Red and Chad McFall did our badge in 2013. So having the ability to pick up the phone, I said, hey, you know what? Have Red send us an extra black badge for this year. So we have a red badge or a black badge specifically for you with a little special something on it for you. Yes, it actually has the DerbyCon Twitter feed going to it. So anytime that a Twitter feed updates for you, the lights will flash and a cute little image will pop up for you.
Is it a clown?
Every time a Twitter hits, you get a clown face.
I thought you wanted me to wear this.
We'll put a smiley face. Now, the fun part about that is, that's it, keep it close to your heart. The fun part about that is Evan is actually sitting on the phone with Redverse, and Redverse is making that happen.
That's awesome.
From another state. So if I asked him to, yeah, all he's got to do is hit a button and it actually sends it specifically to Dave's badge. So when you come to Con, that's it, baby.
Wait, why are you putting at clowns at DerbyCon? You don't want to associate those two. No!
There we go! That's it!
You better not. You know I'll pay you back.
That's it. So, I want to say thank you.
everybody that worked over at Dicon and everybody that made it possible. Thank you so much.
Wow, amazing. I'm totally honored and speechless on that front. And, you know, again, SkyDogCon, another family conference. I highly recommend going out there with those folks. Again, you know, exactly what we're trying to do here. Thank you very much. Speechless. Mr. Scott White? So funny story about Scott real quick. So Scott works with us here, and a few years ago I said, hey, Scott, you know, when we first started DerbyCon, I'm like, hey, can you help us build the CTF? He's like, yeah. He's like, what do you want me to do? I'm like, I've never built a CTF. It's pretty much how I operate. I'm like, hey, I don't know how to do sound. You know how to do it? Yeah, I know how to do sound. Okay, can you do it? Sure, okay. I don't know what that means, but that's fine. And Scott's been running the CTF year after year, and I feel like this year, we by far had one of the best CTFs that we ever had. I mean, network-wise, everything else. And that was a lot of credit to Dustin over there who donated, a checkpoint for us to be able to use during the conference. So can you stand up real quick here? I'd like to say thank you. Year after year, he helps us out, gets us better equipment. And also from the sponsors of the CTF, Cyber Reason, without them, we wouldn't have had the equipment that we did to make it successful. So it was a fantastic, CTF event this year. I mean, I came downstairs, I think it was Thursday or Friday, whenever the CTF came off, and I had to deal with some police issues or something. But anyways, it's fine. No big deal. That's normal. I went downstairs, and it's like 4 o'clock in the morning, and there's, you know, people still awake, you know, in the CTF room, and they're like wide awake, like, you know, having a good time and smiling, and they're just hacking into stuff. I'm like, wow, that's amazing that, you know, that the folks are doing that. So a lot of great folks here, really appreciate everybody that contributed to the CTF making that possible. So let's give a round of applause to Jeff Walton. Where's he at? Jeff Lyon? All right. Jeff Walton also helped out quite a bit. Scott and everybody else that made the CTF possible. Thank you.
Well, we had another successful CTF. I want to thank everybody for playing. Here's a screenshot of the scoreboard for some of you that may have not seen it. And at the last moment, we had someone submit a flag with 3,500 points, and I believe they moved up to third place. So we've got choice of prizes here. We've got 10 prizes. Again, thank Cyber Reason for sponsoring. So if we do have the teams here, I don't know who they are, but I can't even read it. What's the first one? Is that team name? Yeah, dollar team name?
Yeah.
Okay, a few stats. 137 teams registered, so that could be one person, multiple people. Not sure what that is. We'd like to leave it open so anybody can play for 5 minutes or the whole weekend. 1,435 total flags were submitted by all teams, and also a lot of people doing typos or submitting things they think are a flag, so we've had some other invalid ones as well. So a few stats there. And dollar team name if you're in the building. And you've got your choice of the prizes you'd like. We've got all sorts of things up here. A black badge, a free ticket to DerbyCon next year. Yeah. Well,
I think we have to go with
that. All right. Yes. Excellent.
Give it a round of applause.
Scott. Scott.
You guys come up here real quick and fill out the award.
We have Eversec. Second place. Congratulations, guys. Get a choice of whatever you'd like. It's a new Proxmark kit, so you can clone badges and stuff like that. So, congratulations, guys. Spicy Weasel. Congratulations. And here's what we have left. Some lock picks. Super Tooth 1. Land tap, $200. All right. Thank you. Paid to penetrate? Paid to penetrate here?
She's like all the way over there. Last round.
Don't want to take all the credit, huh? Free ticket. Nice win. C3. Congratulations. Free tickets getting donated to the Hackers for Charity. These gentlemen are going to do the same and donate their, it's the Odroid. Awesome. Unicorn poo. Congratulations.
Did you know that unicorns aren't rainbows?
And can you hold up your slap bracelets here? You got their own unicorn poo slap bracelets. All right. So they're donating the Uber Tooth 1 to Hackers for Charity as well. Slackers.
Thank you, Unicorn Poo. I just wanted to say.
Congratulations. 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 All right, they're going with the, okay. Sparrow's lockpicks getting donated to Hackers for Charity. Some random name? Congratulations. Congratulations. All right, great. Again, $50 iTunes donated to Hackers for Charity. Nanerpone? No Nanerpone? All right. Capture the Frank? Congratulations. 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 All right. $50 for Amazon for Hackers for Charity. Thank you, guys. Congratulations. ZFO?
Oh, but not the real one.
I know one of them, but I don't see them. Hillary's sysadmins. I don't know how they got up there, but are they here? So for those of you that didn't play the CTF, we kind of had a political theme where you broke into the RNC... you know, DNC, Hillary's email server and stuff, so. All right. Yeah. <That's>... Late start. A late start. Colonel Sanders? Colonel Sanders? The throwing star Lance Tap Pro is what's left. Can we go ahead? Congratulations, guys. Thank you. So we've got 8 prizes donated. That just, as Dave said, the attendees, you guys are amazing. So, thank you.
Just so you know, for the auction, I signed this, the Dave K. Shake Weight, and I signed it and I put DerbyCon 6 on it too. So, and you also get the other 19 with this as well. So, yeah. Josh, you're sick, man. You're sick. Okay. Hey, Chris, you here? Chris, you go over here. Chris, where you at? Where's she at?
Stand up.
Stand up, Chris. So look back there, Chris. Everybody see back there? She helps us so much with the conference. Everything from grabbing the folks, at the airport, met the man in Red Man and everybody else and dealing with all the craziness that comes along with that. Making sure the speaker rooms are ready. She is so invaluable to us as a team. So I just want to give her a round of applause and thank her. Did anybody here use the shuttle? Look at that. That's great. We're going to continue to do that. I want to get, Finn's not here, but I'd like to thank Finn as well for going back and forth and shuttling everybody during that time. Hopefully that was great for folks. So a round of applause for Finn. Adrian?
Hi, folks. As you know, I do video for Derbycon and a small selection of other conferences around the country. And video was a little bit different this year. We tried some new things. I remember when Dave first discussed doing video streaming to the internet and to the rooms with me. It was when I saw it announced on Twitter that we were going to do it. Jason Ashton and Dave Lauro were trying to get everything to work for the rooms. I don't think we ever quite got to the rooms. But for next year, we got rooms. We got it mostly going to Twitter. We're going to try, going to YouTube. We're going to try being next year to do some bandwidth allocation to make sure that gets out there. But it hopefully mostly worked. I'm going through and getting the sounds amplified and removing noise and so forth. So I hope we get most of that out, in the next couple of days. I only got the first day up so far. But it's working along. Well, that's on my website and index. As far as on YouTube, I got a lot of today up, too. But it's processing. But I'd like to thank my team real quick. Sabrina, some Ninja Master, Glenn Barrett, Dave Lauer, Jordan Muir, Brandon Granati, Joey, Fozzie, Knight Carnage, Evan Davidson, Chris Bridwell, Rick Hayes, Tim Selter, Lisa Philpott, Ben Pendergraft, Sarah Clark, Asiatic Nerd, Corey Hurst, Sam Remington, Barbie and Chris Bristle. Unfortunately, a few of them couldn't make it this year because Tim got in a motorcycle accident. He's fine, but he cracked a couple ribs. But but other than that, he's okay. But video is processing, and a big round of applause for my video team. Thank you very much for all your work. And we'll have it all out there shortly.
Mr. Koblitz.
Hello, everybody. First thing I'd like to do is thank the staff. Registration went so beautifully. That was really a concern of ours this year with where registration was moved to. But I got to say, they did such a wonderful job of keeping the lines down. So let's hear a round of applause for the staff. Secondly, I'd like to thank the entire security team. Every single one of you guys did such an awesome job this year. Please stand up. Please. very special thank you to Jim for dealing with the schedule for me. I know it's a monumental task. And also a very special thank you to Zero, my right-hand man. Speaking of, he has a few things he'd like to say.
Thank you. And thank you very much for coming into this nearly completely blind and pulling off what I think was pretty successful. Yeah? So, there's a lot of things that go on here that really make this great, and I just want to talk about a little example of that. This is supposed to be about family, right? We're supposed to be a one big family. And I really don't think that the first-year attendees understand that when they walk in the door. So I want to give a couple of really great stories of things that have happened in the last couple of days. We have our own resident shenanigans team, mostly led by Evil Moog here, but also the Church of Wi-Fi group in general helps out. They throw things off the 18th floor with parachutes, and the hotel says, "That was cool. Can we get 5 minutes warning next time so our people can come out?" You know why that happens and the rest of you get yelled at? Because he comes to us, we talk to the hotel, we plan it, we run safety checks. Before he does all of these crazy things, we do test drops, we talk to security staff, and they love us for it. And we want more of that to happen, so talk to us. Let's be silly together. Some of this stuff is fun if we can do it safely. I think there's still tricycle races going on, and that's great. Last night, I think, is the best example of the DerbyCon family that I've ever seen, and so I really want to highlight a couple of people. The first one, and feel free to not stand up if I'm embarrassing you horribly, DerbyCon 2, Thursday night, a guy almost got kicked out of the conference. He was just a little too belligerently drunk and running his mouth to, like, one of the very few people that could pull your badge before you even had a badge. No. Last night, that same person, 4 years later, found an intoxicated attendee in the bar who had no room, no way to get home except for his car keys, and was trying to leave. He stopped him, found one of our staff, who called me down to help interface. We got everything cleaned up. Everything was going well. The guy gave up his keys. Everybody was happy. And then we got another call that somebody was passed out in the men's room. So at 3 o'clock in the morning, I made a call. Hey, is there a medic still on the radio by chance? And Buckaroo's like, my exact words were, there's somebody in the men's room. He's probably covered in his own puke. I need help. Is there a medic still around? And
no.
Okay. Please, Quadlin, correct me.
By the way, Josh doesn't need a microphone. It's the weirdest thing. It's like he's talking in a microphone.
So for the
it's amazing.
For the second time, that night, Buckaroo shows up to help somebody in the same stall of the men's room downstairs. This time, no socks, no shoelaces, but he was wearing pants, and we all really appreciate that. He spent an hour and a half with this guy, getting him to a point where we could put him in a cab and send him home. And this is what family is people with what I would call really overdeveloped sense of duty and family just coming together and helping out. A lot of times it feels like we have far more than 40 people on the security team because you guys are watching out for each other. And that's what matters, and that's what this is about. Everyone watches out for each other except for Tim. That's right. But no, I can't stress enough. This is family, and now that it's closing ceremonies, you all know. So share that with everybody else and make the family bigger next year.
One last thing I'd like to say is I would like to thank every single one of you for helping us. Every time we had to clear a room to get talk, everyone was very compliant and left in an orderly fashion. Unfortunately, sometimes we had to turn some people away from talks. Sorry that happens. Hopefully we can catch them online. So thank every one of you. Give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you.
So again, thank you everybody who made this possible and the folks that we may not have mentioned that contribute and help. I mean, you know, the crypto challenge and everything around that, and, you know, getting the things printed. I mean, everybody just contributed in a lot of different ways. So we're so humble about the support, because every year we get better, and the reason why we get better is because of folks like you. So thank you very much. The HFC auction. Johnny, we were on here. So if you're new to this, every year, you know, there was an HFC auction that happened, well, yesterday, I believe, right? And that went very well. In fact, I heard the Rance badge went for over $2,000, which is insane. I hope I'm not saying anything you were going to say right there. So, totally messed that up. Do you need 19 more? I have 19 more of those if you need them, but... No, but, you know, it goes to a great cause. You know, we've supported Johnny since day one from Derbycon 1. Every year we continue to break records, and every year we support them. And, you know, it's not a competitiveness with other conferences, but if you look at other conferences, i.e. like someone like DEF CON, for example, you know, we raise year after year more than DEF CON ever does every year. And it's a competitive thing, which is great. So not anything against DEF CON, but just kind of shows you, you know, the kind of folks that we have here and what they do. So what we do is we have a few things we auction off, you know, and welcome the bid and all that good stuff on it. And we also are going to be donating a black badge for auction as well. So a black badge right here, which is lifetime access into DerbyCon. There's no foreseeable future when we're stopping to do it, but I'm not sure we're going to do 47 of them is how much I went to last time. But I think I might pass it off to somebody after that. Who knows? But we'll see. Aaron's like, she already runs it anyway, pretty much for me, so on my side. But yeah, I'll pass it over to Johnny.
Thanks. Before we do the auction, I just want to sort of echo some of the stories, you know, that have already been told, but also tell you a few more of our own that are very personal. First of all, as most of you know, I'm back from Uganda, which is pretty amazing. But the support that you guys gave me while I was over there, I mean, it's been 7 years of living over there, and you guys have made that possible, all the work that we did over there. And that started, you know, obviously that started before DerbyCon, but it was right around that time where I went, and everything sort of clicked when DerbyCon started and our support started coming in. So that's the first thing I want to do is I want to thank you guys for that, because we couldn't have done that work without you. Seriously, that was amazing. But coming into Louisville this time was so different for me because, first of all, it was a real short flight. I didn't have 30 hours in the air anymore, you know, 30-plus hours. It was like two. It was really boring. But, you know, I get into Louisville, and even before the conference started, I could already tell that something was very different. It wasn't just that now I live here again. It was something was changing. And it started even before the conference did, and just meeting everybody and talking to them. But we had 10 people from DerbyCon that went with us on Friday morning. Actually, we could only schedule it. Oh, it's really scary. We could only schedule it during opening ceremonies, which was unfortunate, but 10 people missed opening ceremonies to go to Hotel Louisville and just sit with some folks that are in Hotel Louisville, which is a transitional home, and sit with women who are struggling with all sorts of different things and their life's kind of a wreck. And we sat down and talked to them about, you know, what are your concerns? How do you need help? You know, what things can we teach you? And they wanted to know about things like passwords and how to keep people from stalking them online. And so, you know, like 10 people gave up opening ceremonies to go down there. And we thought maybe this would be a 1 or 2 hour thing, and it turned into a whole weekend event where we were back and forth to Hotel Louisville because they were like, we want you guys to come back, and there's, you know, DerbyCon and Hackers for Charity shirts all over that place now, and they were just thrilled at that. And that was before the conference began. You know, this sense of family, this idea that we're a family just kept growing on me. And I get into the conference, I see, you know, things all over the place. You know, I see... you know, I see Eddie down there doing his artwork and just sitting there for hours and hours, spending all that time down there doing that great work to raise money to make projects like that possible, basically giving up his whole conference to make that happen. You know, I look at, thank you, Eddie. Hey, thank you, Eddie. You know, I see BourbonCon, I see the, you know, all the effort they put in to do that, and I see the money going, you know, to help raise money for cancer. You know, I see, I see all the vendors that are around that donated things to help us out. Bill over at No Starch has just been a great guy to all of us in the community. He helps us out every year. You know, everybody that's back there in that vendor room, it kicks in to add, you know, support to the work that we're doing, and that's just killer.
We have people, you know, Emily sat and did this amazing quilt. Somebody quilting, you know, all through the year, spending all this time to give this thing over to raise money to do projects like that. All of this, the CTF blows me away. I mean, again, these are people that gave of their entire conference, you know, sitting and pounding on that CTF, you know, through all hours and just grinding on that stuff just to give up the winnings. You know, that sense of family is just absolutely astounding to me.
And in addition, I don't know if you're aware, Jenny, but we had $1,500 in donations from the speaker honorarium. So speakers giving up their own money to come here to talk, getting to talk and donating that to HFC as well. So,
right. I mean,
amazing.
All the time that goes into putting a talk together, it's, you know, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of effort. And that little bit of money is a nice token that's, you know, appreciated. And it really is. It's real nice. And just to give that up. You know, and thanks for the shake weights. That's a really nice, very awkward donation.
I'm so excited about those.
I think we have a big pile of post-exploitation towels that we could put with those? Do we have those? Okay, because that'll make a nice, sorry. There's this.
I'm confused.
Yeah, and so that's, you know, and other magical things happened to me during this conference. I had a friend of mine come to me and he said, you know, I had this great conversation with someone and they want to start up a nonprofit. They have something that's really close to them personally that, you know, they want to stand up this nonprofit. And I thought about you. Could we sit down and have lunch? And sat down and had lunch and I had this amazing conversation about this other nonprofit that's going to be popping up in this community just directly geared towards bringing people together, you know, in this community that might feel like they're alone, you know, dealing with stuff. That is a lot of shake weight. Wow. And so I don't want to take up too much time, but I have to tell you about one story that just absolutely blew me away that happened at our live auction over at the booth. Some of you guys know that Rance won a black badge last year, and there was a big session where we went back and forth, and it was him and Army Train going back and forth trying to win this black badge. And Rance beat out Army Train to win this black badge, and the final price was $1,337. That was his $1,337.
3 years ago.
3 years ago, I'm sorry, yeah. And so that we always remembered that, how competitive it was, and that it was kind of friendly. Well, this year, that badge went up for auction again. That same badge went up for auction, and it was a slugfest. And it went back and forth because everybody was like, this is a special piece of our community. And BK steps in and he was just like, you know, this thing was going crazy. He's like, 2048, 2048. Everybody was like, holy crap. Josh just broke. He was like, what? Like from that amount of money. And everybody was just absolutely stunned, and I was like, holy crap. Oh. He's bidding against Army Train's girlfriend, and I'm like, this makes it even worse. Like, she's trying to win it back for Army Train, and she couldn't win it because he just beat her out. And he puts that bid down and turns around and says, I'm going to make this a living memorial. This thing is going to circulate through the hacker community. Every year, somebody different is going to get it. It's going to be a traveling trophy and a memorial to Rance. And the first person that's going to get it is going to be Army Train. I think we need to rename. We need to give you a new handle. I think HFC Santa is definitely a good one for you. It's pretty good. And so that was really infectious. In fact, the auction turned into people going and competing against each other and giving each other dirty looks and getting real agitated to beat somebody out and then win something and then hand it to them. You know, like it was just. And like you said, this is kind of a weird family because that kind of crap doesn't happen in my family, but. You know, that's just really awesome. And it was all, yeah. Right.
Bunch of nerds. Yes, that's right. That's right. He's in trouble. He is. Hi, we love you, Army Trained. So, the last thing that I'll say is that all these stories are really great, but, you know, it only means so much if it stays within this conference. You know, if it stays here and dies here, it doesn't mean that much. The most encouraging thing that I saw was, I don't know if you guys were aware, there were a whole bunch of college students that were here this weekend that spent, you know, the whole conference. And they came into a hacker conference and they saw all this. And I don't know what your first hacker conference was like, right? Yeah, right? My first hacker conference, I came in and I was like, this is how I have to act to be a hacker. And it was not a positive environment. It was a negative environment. And I felt like I had to emulate that in a lot of ways and be sort of a negative, you know, whatever when I'm at the conference. And then I can go home and be, you know, something different. And you guys showed that that is just not the case, that you can be powerfully positive people who care about each other, who really go out of their way to show love for each other. And that is thanks to you guys. I mean, the staff that put all this time and effort into making this happen not only made a successful conference, you're literally changing the future of this community in a positive way. You're affecting thousands of lives by doing this. And I just give you guys a huge round of applause for that. Thank you. So without further ado, let's do an auction real quick. I know I ran late, but I just wanted to get that all out. Thanks for giving me the time to do that.
By the way, if the college kids were here on Saturday, I apologize for that late night. It was kind of crazy. So, you know, the party? Yeah. I'm still positive.
Testing. Okay. So we have several things to auction off today. Quite a few things were donated, and apparently we've got something special for the shake weights, and that terrifies me. The quilt. Oh, wow. Oh, dear God, that's gorgeous. These are beautiful, beautiful t-shirts and logos, and just put on a beautiful quilt. It'll keep you warm, or it'll keep your wall warm, because that's a piece of art. I'm impressed. That's, wow, does anybody remember that? All in the Family, Security B-Side, Secure Ninja, this is gorgeous. So just to be clear, we have several items. We have the quilt, we have a lovely bat, we have, I'm still terrified of the damn shake weights.
You can be like Nathan. That's all you use.
There's another motion you're familiar with. Anyway, come on, we're all thinking it. I do have a few things to warm up the crowd. And I think that we're going to be throwing some from over there as well. Come here, Chris. So we're going to auction off the bat, we're going to auction off the quilt, and Gillis has mentioned that we're going to be doing something else as well. Gillis has been carrying our little friend here around all weekend, and he offered it up for auction. Although I think we should auction it and give it to Dave to take home. Because if there's any other thing scarier than a skeleton Father Christmas clown nose thing, I'm not sure what the hell it is. He's not that skinny. Anyway, start throwing him. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go with the quilt first. And that's gorgeous. Look at all those hands up. Look at all those bids. We're going to start with $100. Thanks, Jason. Who'll give me $200? I've got $200. Who'll give me $300? $300. Who'll give me $400? $400. Who'll give me $500? Where have I got $5? Renderman, $500. Who'll give me $600? Okay, stop throwing. I'm going to start taking their damn bids. Look. Yeah, seriously, if you have not been to one of my auctions before, don't raise your hands. Okay, I'm giving you this warning once. Yeah, well, okay, you always look funny, but Look, his wife laughed. Okay, I've got a $500 bid from Render Man. Who'll give me $600? Hi, Angel. Well done. The gauntlet has been dropped. Ladies and gentlemen, I've got $1,337. Who'll give me more? There's only a very few specific bids I'll take above that. Come on. I have $1,337. Going once for the elite hacker number. Going twice for the number you all know and dread seeing in horrible missives from weird places. Sold, Angel. Well done. Not bad. Not bad. That was not bad at all. Let's do the bat. Eddie, stand up. Eddie, you did this? Don't take out the video camera. Don't take out the video camera. Jesse, stand. Come here. Justin, stand up. Jesse, Justin, they got the bat. Jesse's in the back, Justin's in the front, and Eddie did the art. This is impressive. Derbycon 2016, the Louisville Slugger. It's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Jason Street is throwing a shake weight. That's just, God bless it, terrifying. He's so determined. He's like, yeah, I'm going to get this. Who'll give me $100 for the bat? I've got $100. Who'll give me $150? I've got $150. Who'll give me $200? I've got $200. Who'll give me $250? I've got $250. Who'll give me $3? Jason's actually double-fisting shake weights. I've got $350? $300? $350. I've got $350. Who'll give me $4? I've got four. Who'll give me $450? I've got $450. Who'll give me $5? Going one. Dear God, he dropped a shake. Do you not know how to handle things like that?
Oh!
Not that size. That's not what he said last night. Hey, this is called innuendo. It's okay. They did it in Tom and Jerry. I can do it here. Anyway. Where were you at 5? You're at 5. You're at 5. I've got 5. Who'll give me $550? Going once for $500? Stand up. Stand up. Everybody say hello.
Hello.
When do you get to see him again? What's that? Before Shmoo. That's all we need to know. Congrats. 700. Going once for 700. Anybody want to do 768? Going twice for 700. If you haven't seen Eddie Mize's art, it's because you're stupid. Because he sat across from the coat check and the t-shirt sales and registration when it moved over there all weekend for $0.00 to donate all the money that he made off of those pictures with his hands and his heart and his soul and his amazing artistic talent all weekend and did that and didn't go to talks and got to talk to people that walked by and looked at his art, but didn't get to do anything else because he chose to for family, for community, for us. So thank you, Eddie. And that's where the money went. So he's not just coming out of pocket for time. He's not just coming out of pocket for materials. He's not just coming out of pocket for life that he gets to skip by not being there. He's coming out of pocket with money. Not bad. 2048. Does anybody want to beat it? I'm not complaining. Justin, don't raise your arm like that. Going once. Yeah, your girlfriend's like, oh, fiance is like, you. Going once for 2048. Going twice for 2048. Sold. No. He just said, sell it again. I've got $700. Who'll give me more? Who'll give me 768? And no, I'm not joking. You said that? Oh, I'm sorry. No, you raised your arm.
No, I said that. Totally.
He raised his arm. I think I should take
the bid.
Who thinks? Who thinks I should take the bid from? I've got 768 on it from Dave. Who'll give me more? Going once for 768. Going twice for 768. 1,000. What the? You can thank him now, Dave.
Thank you. I almost was sleeping on the couch tonight.
The day's not over yet. Going once for 1,024. Going twice for 1,024. Sold for 1,020. You son of a bitch. I have 768. I told you the day wasn't over, dude. I told it to you. I told you that. Who'll give me more than 768? Did she hit him yet? Oh, would you like to hold this for a second? He can pick up a shake weight and try to defend himself. Going once for 768. Going.
Thank you.
Going once for 769. Going, oh God, I have to say those numbers again. Going twice for 769. Sold for $769 to Angel. So, we just made about $4,000 on this bet. Nice job, Johnny. Nice job, gentlemen, ladies. A lot.
Thank you again.
Blue Knight, you guys deliver that to her, okay? Was that it? Are we doing shake weights? Okay. And we have a black badge, don't we? Oh, so HFC will be over on the side afterwards. If anything you want to talk to them about or donate anything, that'll be there. This is one of the... Yeah, let's show the new one. This is cool. This is beautiful. Like, this is really, really sexy beautiful. How many LEDs are in this thing? Dear God, and how much sleep have you gotten in the last week? Explains a lot. Well, I mean, that's you, so what are we going to do? By the way, he makes the coolest little things you plug into a USB power pack. They're either like party lights or they're a beautiful flashlight that lasts for weeks. Janitor, where are you? How long did this, the six LED flashlight last in that little power pack you have? Oh, I'm sorry, my bad. Anyway, so the beautiful little flashlight power pack thing for your USB power packs. So we're doing a black badge. Money goes to HFC. Ladies and gentlemen, who'll start me off with a bid? Nathan, all right! The dirty! Nathan has got 1337 on the black badge. Who's going to give me more? I want to see 2048, 2048, 2048, 2048. Come on. I've got 2048! Yes, that's correct. This is in dollars, not tacos, Nathan, okay? I've got 2048. Who'll give me more than 2048? I want to see something more. 40 integral 4096. Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we're cooking with fire, like tacos. So, ladies and gentlemen, I've got 4096. Who'll give me more? You do not have to roll up in another multiplier. Okay? But you can roll up in, you know, I don't know, something else. 4,100? 4,200? How about 4,500? Who'll give me 4,500? Any more bids? 4096 is respectable. I'm not complaining. It's not as good as last year. Integral? Ladies and gentlemen, going once for 4096. Going twice for 4096. Sold. What? I have 4,600 from Integral. I'm going once at 4,600. I have somebody checking a bank account. Yeah, okay, we're waiting for Army trains. Yeah, Integral, stand up. Angel, stand up. Come on. That's not exactly a multiplier, but okay. But that's definitely Army trained. I've got 4669. What's that? Let's just go to 5. It's like the Spinal Tap, but mine goes to 11. We've got $5,000 on the black badge. Going once at 5,000. Waiting for the lag. Going twice at 5,000. Waiting for the lag. Sold! $5,000!
Andy, love you, man. That's awesome.
Hey, Mr. Blinky Bling.
Love you.
We're going to make him one of these, right?
So is this bad time to say last year's or next year's our last year at Derbycon? Or no, I'm just kidding. Just kidding. Totally a joke.
I think Mr. Blinky Bling will perhaps manufacture a badge for him. Fantastic. I'm going to steal 30 seconds. How much will you pay me to take this away?
Oh, hey, Josh. Free ticket for next year.
Oh!
And then that was it.
So I appreciate you guys so much. I love you guys so much. And we're going to do everything we can to stretch every dollar of that and do a lot of good with it. So thank you guys. We're out of time. I've already run really long. And I know everybody's got flights to catch. It's been a long show. So we're going to move this stuff to eBay auctions. Also,
yeah.
Is this going to become like the Stargate?
Good and all Lord. The donations from the CTF as well will be
yes,
on there as well. Thank
that's
you
all
going to
be
so
on there,
everybody.
As well as our last coin auction. This is from the Crypto Challenge crew. We you guys saw the small coin at the booth. This is the large coin. It's one of a kind. It's a set of two, number 1057. There are too many details to even talk about on this stage. But we're going to put the... Oh, that's... It's really kind of creepy. Oh, actually, that feels kind of good. But so anyway, we're going to have this all up on eBay. But I thank you guys so much for your time. Thank you for letting me take up so much of the ceremonies. I just love you guys. Thanks so much.
Yep. Test. Deviant, you here real quick? Deviant? Is he here? Come here real quick. You want to hack the Derby real quick? Want to announce the winners?
Thank you, everybody. This was the return of Hack Your Derby. Who remembers the original Hack Your Derby by Space Rogue ages ago? So that was great, and we missed that, so we pulled it back together. I really want to thank Snooze and Eddie and Tara who came together to judge with me. Eddie wrangled amazing prizes from the Pinnacle Group. We also have to thank Milton, like we kind of took over your space. I didn't know the inflatable couches were someone's booth. I thought they were just like a hangout area, so we were there the whole time, and everyone did an amazing job. We had some people build their derbies at home, which a lot of people did in the past. Some people built them on site, which was amazing. On site, some of the best ones. Investigator Chick made a cool cat hat. There was the Touch Me hat. It had a touch-sensitive capacitor that would change lights and do fun things. The top in that category, though, someone built a pineapple attack hat on site with Hack 5 gear that they got on site. So that was excellent. That was the winner there. In the homebrew, though, literally, like the Get Swifty hat, the man was like playing, Rick and Morty and serving it up over the network. You could download Rick and Morty episodes. The party hat that was reacting to sound, you might have seen that around. Oh my God. Didn't win. It was so close. In the second place, Integral had the arc, like plasma arc speaker hat, which literally would have violated the rule of don't hurt people if you got too close and put your finger in there. But it was effing gorgeous and only missed by 3 points. Top tier, as always, was Hack Your Derby, Hack the Derby. And it was an active CTF in a hat, self-contained. If any of the Hack Derbies are here right now, please stand up and please, please applaud for everyone who put something together. It was really great. And we're going to keep doing it next year. If we can be back, we're going to come back with new categories. Just follow Hack Your Derby on Twitter. And thank you so much for letting us do it, man.
A round of applause for Deviant taking his own time with folks and building a derby. This is an awesome thing. So we are going to wrap up and call DerbyCon 6 closed. But that doesn't mean that we're not going to be back, right? We're going to be back next year in full force, right? Take what we're doing here and spread it. Spread it across the industry and the community. What's that? Oh, we got one more thing. In the middle of like doing a cool speech. Matthew Lichtenberger and Aaron Guzman, are you here? No? Aaron just walked out, okay? No, we got the honorariums for them, it's fine. But take what you're doing here and spread it to the industry. With our minds together, we can be creative and do what we're doing and make things different and do things for the better. The research that we're doing, everything from, you know, going offense, I mean, Harmjoy's talk on Empire, what he's been able to do with PowerShell, and just having, I mean, we had the father of PowerShell here talking about, you know, how important it is. And it's funny because he mentioned my talk at DEF CON around PowerShell, and during that time, you know, the conversations that I had back and forth with Microsoft and PowerShell were not good. But they've changed. And people recognize the importance of security research and what we're doing. People recognize that we have to have defense. We're changing the industry and doing it in a positive note and taking what you do here and spreading that across the rest of the industry is going to make it better. So take what you do here and move it forward, okay? And I always do a video at the end, and I'm really proud about this video, this one. Spent a lot of time on this, and so what's going to happen after this? Once the video ends, that's it, and we'll all walk out, and that'll be DerbyCon, but we'll see you back next year, all right? Yeah.
But everything at all just feels the same. At my high school, it felt more to me like a jail cell, a penitentiary. My time spent there, it only made me sick. And I don't ever wanna be like you. I don't wanna do the things you do. I'm never gonna hear the words you say. And I don't ever wanna be you. Just like you. Oh, what I'm saying is, this is the anthem. Throw all your hands up, you don't wanna be you. Go to college, a university, get a real job, that's what they said to me. But I could never live the way they want. Do my time on a step while they all get in line. I'm just a minor threat, so pay no mind. Do you really wanna be like them? Do you really wanna be another trend? Do you wanna be part of that crowd? Cause I don't ever wanna be you. Don't wanna be just like you. Oh, what I'm saying is, this is the anthem. Throw all your hands up, yeah. I wanna be you. Shaking on my stage, boy.
anthem. Throw all your hands up. Y'all got to feel me. Sing if you're with me. Yeah. Don't wanna be just like you.
Just like you.
This is the anthem. Throw all your hands up. Y'all got to feel me. Sing if you're with me. Another loser anthem. Another loser anthem. Another loser anthem. Another loser anthem.
Hope is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore and love.
L